I certainly read Jules Verne at the prep school. They had a quite decent library there, although it was such a barbaric place. The library was good, and I could always escape to the library. And so the more, in a way, the more barbaric it was, the better
the libraries
seemed to be. And so I read a lot of Jules Verne there, and they had a good encyclopedia there, which was actually a wonderful source of knowledge. I remember in the encyclopedia there, I learned about electrons and protons. They had an article about electrons and protons. And I was very frustrated because it turned out, I mean, they had this long article all about electrons and protons. They told us everything about electrons and nothing about protons. And I decided right then that I should find out more about protons. I mean, it was clear that, in fact, at that time, almost nothing was known about protons. So that was clearly the way to go. And so that came as a very early, that feeling that there was something unknown, mm-hmm. that electrons were already to a great extent done, and protons clearly were not, which of course was true at that time. So that library had in it certainly Jules Verne, and probably, I don't know whether they had Wells, but certainly I discovered Wells pretty soon afterwards, and I read that the classic Wells books, Tono-Bungay and the mm-hmm. the Time Machine and The Island of Dr. Moreau, all these marvelous mm-hmm. books, which are great as literature as well as being
imaginative.
Well, rather in mediocre science, but I mean, Wells was a far greater writer than he was a scientist.